Hello there, and welcome to this episode of Inside Sphere. My name's Julian David, and I'm here at my own satellite studio to walk you through the basic controls and main features of the Townsend Labs Sphere plugin. Instead of just talking about it, though, I have picked a range of examples from actual productions so you can hear the mic and the plugin in action. If you've just invested into the L22 and want to hit the ground running, I highly recommend that you check out our quick start video right up here. The Sphere plugin runs natively within any DAW that supports AAX, VST, and AU. When used with this native plugin, the Sphere system works really well with a wide range of audio interfaces and preamps. It also runs with extremely low latency and guaranteed real-time performance on the UAD platform with an Apollo or Arrow interface by Universal Audio. I'm going to focus on the Sphere plugin that is bundled with the L22 mic, but the controls are identical with add-on plugins for use with the L22, like the UAD Oceanway mic collection, for example. So no matter which plugin you're using, all of the tips in this tutorial will apply. And what's really cool is that even if you don't own the L22 yet, you can still follow along. Simply go to townsendlabs.com, create your account, and download the Sphere plugin as well as some sample content for free. Check out the direct link in the description below. When you instantiate the plugin for the first time, it shows up with what we call the single view. This view gives you immediate access to all the key controls you need to get a great sound in no time. And remember that all of these parameters can be adjusted either while you're tracking or later during mixing. On the left, you'll find the currently selected mic model, and you can quickly cycle through the available emulations by clicking on the mic image. In most cases, this is all you really need to do to achieve a great recording. A single left click selects the next model, while right click or control click takes you back to the previous one. Alternatively, you can browse the complete list of mic models by clicking the name below the image. Sphere comes with a great ever-expanding collection of currently more than 20 sought-after mics. So let's dive in and have a listen. Here's a vocal track from a song I recently produced and mixed. By the way, this is what a typical vocal track recorded with Sphere looks like. It's a stereo file with a lot more output on the left channel, which records the front of the mic. Let's have a listen to this performance and try out a couple of mics.
Hello, patterns. Welcome to my patterns. Hello, patterns. Hello.
We just had a listen to four classic mic models. The 47 has a really rich lower mid-range that is typically great on a lot of vocals, but doesn't quite cut it for me on this track. The 67 is even darker and is a great choice for electric guitars, for example, but not for this particular vocal. The 800G is super bright and maybe even a little bit over the top for this one, so I ended up with the LD12 model. You might like something different, but for me this works really well within the track. So let's listen to the whole thing in context one more time. Let's start with the 47.
Hello, patterns. Welcome to my patterns. Hello, patterns. Hello.
Perfect. That works really well for me. So let's have a look at the other controls available to us in the Sphere plugin. Up first is the pattern control, which lets you select the polar pickup pattern of the L22 mic. Basically, it controls the direction from which the mic is picking up sound. This is essentially the same as choosing a polar pattern on any regular multi-pattern mic, but with the additional advantage of being able to select intermediate polar patterns that the original mic might not even have. While cardioid generally works great in a lot of applications, other polar patterns can turn out to be a real lifesaver. For example, you might want to use an omni pattern to capture several singers around one mic. Or how about a figure of eight pickup to reject specific sound sources in a room? I like to think of polar patterns as the DNA of microphones. The particular on and off axis response of a mic, depending on what polar pattern is selected, is largely what gives that mic its unique character. Generally, all of the options available on the original mics are highlighted in green color. In the case of the polar patterns, selecting a highlighted pattern gives you the full 360 response of the original mic at this particular setting and how it would react and capture sound in a real space. Moving to the right, we have the polar meter, which provides a visual representation of the currently selected polar pattern and potential access control adjustments. But the polar meter also dynamically displays the approximate amplitude and direction of sound arriving at the mic. One unique feature of the technology behind Sphere is that the system can identify the direction of where sound is coming from, which is in fact important for the precise pattern modeling that Sphere does. In practice, the polar meter can be quite useful to identify bleed from other instruments and to tweak the polar pattern accordingly for best rejection of that unwanted sound. There's one other thing I'd like to point out to you here. The polar meter also shows you the currently selected pattern of the mic model at 1 kHz. As you browse through the available emulations, you'll see the pattern change from one mic to the next, even though they are technically all cardioids. So one mic's cardioid is not necessarily the same as another mic's cardioid. Let's take the venerable 47, for example. Its cardioid, in fact, turns out to be more like a supercardioid. These are the little details that end up mattering a lot when you want the authentic tone of those iconic microphones with all their idiosyncrasies. Sphere is a dual-channel microphone, recording the front and back of the capsule separately, because it's only by having these two channels that modeling the full 360-degree response and proximity effect of the original mics becomes possible, even just in cardioid. Below the pattern control, we first have a couple of high-pass filter settings, as well as the axis control. With axis, you can virtually shift the microphone response around the mic as if you had rotated it. This is indicated by a moving triangle in the polar meter. Keep in mind, though, that this doesn't actually rotate the pattern or directionality. You change the sound, but the pattern stays locked in place. In practice, this is a cool way of adjusting the tonality of a microphone to tame excessive sibilance or fricatives, for example. I actually like to automate this parameter in my DAW instead of using volume automation or a de-esser. Check it out sometime. The fourth control in this section is proximity. The bass response of all directional mics increases as you position the mic closer to the source. This phenomenon is called proximity effect. Rather than just the static EQ, Sphere genuinely allows you to adjust the magnitude of the proximity effect. The default center position provides the best match to the mic being modeled. Positive values increase the bass response, while negative values reduce the bass. Keep in mind that this control has no effect when the pattern is set to omni, because proximity effect only happens for directional patterns such as cardioid and figure of eight. Finally then, we have the reverse button, an output level control, and the output phase button. The reverse button swaps the mic's outputs so it points backwards. Why could this be useful? For instance, to have a quick listen to the sound of ambience pickup or bleed when recording multiple instruments in the same room. Check this out. The output level control allows cutting or boosting the master output up to 12 dB. Last but not least, the output phase button reverses the polarity of the plugin's output, which can be helpful when using multiple mics with different wiring polarities or time alignments. A good example for this would be the top and bottom signals on a snare drum. One final word regarding the output of the Sphere plugin. While any recording made with Sphere is a two-channel recording to begin with, the plugin then takes those two inputs to create a mono signal. In Pro Tools, the plugin will automatically convert the stereo track to a mono track when it's instantiated. In other DAWs and in the UAD version of the plugin, the output will be dual mono, with both channels carrying exactly the same signal. That said, if you're using the dedicated Sphere 180 plugin, you'll always get a true stereo output for a stereo recording. But I'll tell you more about that in a separate video. So that was a walkthrough of the features available in the single view of the Sphere plugin, but just a window into the powerful capabilities of this technology. As a reminder, I'd like to invite you to go to townsendlabs.com, find out more, download the free plugin, and try it out on your own. Also, I'd love to hear your questions in the comments down here. And of course, your likes, shares, and subscribes are much, much appreciated. As a subscriber, you'll be among the first to see the latest content from Townsend Labs. See you next time with a more in-depth look at some of the advanced Sphere features that actually reimagine what you can do with microphones.